the richest collection of Methodist artifacts in the world, including a plaster death mask of John Wesley, 250,000 photographs, and miles of sermons, handwritten notes, and documents by Methodists from Francis Asbury to local lay leaders are housed at the United Methodist General Commission on Archives and History. But the most important mission of the keepers of this treasure trove is to preserve the stories of the people who made the United Methodist Church what it is today.
When you mention archives and history, people have a tendency to think caring for old stuff, cataloging and putting things away, only to be resources drawn on by scholars and historians and museum keepers.
The Reverend Fred Day leads the Archives Agency. Day says people who think of this agency's role as that of a museum have it all wrong. History is alive. Your church's story is the latest chapter in our story.
We just don't put this stuff on a shelf to stay there, but to be a very present and active and lively memory for the church to draw on as it moves into what the future holds with a confidence that through it all, God is with us every step of the way.
The stories of Methodism are captured in meeting minutes and other documents from boards and agencies, as well as personal papers from missionaries and Methodists who made a name for the church.
Those family stories, the regional stories of our town, our community, our state, and of our church, all help define who we are.
This was given to Otterbein, printed in 1747. This is a great find.
Archivists say sometimes looking back opens doors to the future. Mark Sheenice sees himself as a historian and evangelist.
Frequently we have people who are looking for vital church records. And they would mention that I was baptized at such and such a date, such and such a church. I think the pastor's name was this. So we start this rapport and this conversation. After a while, many will say to me, I kind of miss going to the Methodist church. And I always say to them, well, you know, the church is always there for you.
Researchers who come to the archive at Drew University in New Jersey can explore multiple collections. What's important to visitors is that the collection is accessible.
These days, a lot of researchers are used to going to facilities where they have to deal with off-site storage, so they have to place their request the day or a week before they go to the site. It's always a relief to our researchers here to know that we can pull material from the shelves within 15 minutes.
The archive is also putting more and more resources online, including 33,000 pages of photos from 1910 to 1920 that show a day in the life of the church around the world.
It may be images of churches, schools, hospitals, all these things that show the full ministry of the church. Our ministry is not just described by what happens inside the sanctuary. From there we reach out and our ministry touches the individuals and the people around us.
We don't want to be the keepers of treasures that are so sacred they need to be locked away, but make them accessible and available for people to see and know and be inspired by the stories that translate into our story and impact who we are now and who we're living into being in the future.
This video was brought to you by the people of the United Methodist Church through World Service donations.